The goal of our study was to really try to better understand our patients' current understanding and knowledge or knowledge gaps in terms of contraception use, and specifically as it relates to contraception choices when you have an underlying rheumatic disease. So for this specific analysis, we included about 250 individuals who have inflammatory arthritis or lupus and or lupus-like conditions. We compared responses to a number of questions on this topic between the group with inflammatory arthritis and patients with lupus and lupus-like conditions to see if there may be differences in knowledge and knowledge gaps between these groups, as there are known to be some different considerations related to contraception depending on your underlying diagnosis and some medications you may take. So in this study, we assessed sort of two categories of questions. So on the one hand, we looked at we asked a number of questions about the effectiveness of various contraceptive methods. And these were grouped in terms of highly effective reversible contraception, moderately effective reversible contraception, and the least effective, which is really barrier methods, fertility awareness-based methods, and others that really have a high failure rate with typical use. And while we didn't find differences in terms of the responses and correct responses between the groups with inflammatory arthritis and lupus and lupus-like diseases, we did find that overall, about half of respondents to the survey were incorrect when they estimated the effectiveness of the moderate and low effective methods, and typically overestimating when they were incorrect. And so there was one sort of knowledge gap identified from that. We also posed a number of true-false questions about common facts and misconceptions and important things that we would want our patients to know about contraception safety and efficacy, really specifically in the context of having a rheumatic disease. And we compared those responses also between the groups. So those with inflammatory arthritis, how well did they do on that assessment compared to those with lupus? And there were actually some interesting differences between the groups. So overall, respondents did pretty well and got a number of the questions correct. But the comparison was really illuminating because the patients with lupus and lupus-like conditions as compared to those with inflammatory arthritis, they were more likely to endorse contraindications or reasons that someone shouldn't use certain hormone-based and estrogen-based contraceptive methods. And on the one hand, they were more likely to be correct about this in the context of having antiphospholipid antibodies or antiphospholipid syndrome. But they also more commonly reported that this would be a contraindication for all patients with rheumatic diseases, which isn't true.